Okay, let's have another look at oxymercuration. So if we take a look at the alkene that we've drawn, it has an existing chiral center that we've shown with the wedge here. And so we are going to have to pay attention to that as we proceed with the mechanism. But first of all, the things that we remember about oxymercuration that are important is that we form a Markovnikov alcohol, so addition of the more substituted carbon, and we prevent carbocation rearrangements. We could also say that we have a cyclic intermediate, a mercurinium, and we get, because of that, anti-addition. So some of these will be important here. There are examples you could do where the anti-addition is very important when multiple stereocenters are created. And so be careful when you have that situation. And we'll see one of those here. So if we're predicting the products, Markovnikov alcohol, we'll keep everything else the same, and we shall predict the alcohol to be here. However, we have to be careful because we form a chiral center. So we'll say we form, from addition of the mercurinium to the top position, this isomer, and then to the bottom of the alkene, or to the other side, we might form this alcohol. Okay, so we actually form diastereomers and not enantiomers. Because of the existing chiral center. Which is not involved in the reaction. If this were an acid addition, we might get a carbocation rearrangement, but we prevent that with oxymercuration. So let's look at the mechanism. First thing, form the cyclic mercurinium, invoking a lone pair from mercury. And then the opening of the alkene to attack the mercury, eliminating an acetate. And so we have our cyclic intermediate. Say that it forms in this fashion. And then we have our water molecule, which adds, because of the charge buildup, the greater charge buildup at the more substituted carbon, I show that with a bigger delta plus than the smaller delta plus, not needed in the mechanism, just for illustrative purposes. The lone pair of the oxygen attacks the more substituted Markovnikov position, eliminating the mercury. So if we keep everything aligned like we have it here, that would place the oxygen, or the water molecule, to the back, and now the mercury is on an achiral carbon. And when stereochemistry is not, a stereoisomer is not formed, or a chiral center is not formed, that isn't important, but it is here. And so now, we want to invoke more solvent molecule to grab that extra proton, a little acid-base reaction. And we have our alcohol and our mercury complex that we then proceed in step two of the mechanism or of the reaction to eliminate and replace with a hydride from sodium borohydride, which we will not worry about that mechanism at this time as it's in a later chapter. And so we have one of our possible isomers. And addition of the mercury to the other side of the double bond would have formed the enantiomer, or excuse me, the diastereomer of this compound.